Ryan Van Duzer. I made The Wonders of the Fragile Reef here. It's a project I've been working on for almost 2 years in total. I'm a biologist. I'm a teacher, high school teacher. I teach marine biology. So it's something I've wanted to do my whole life since I was a little kid, and finally found the inspiration and really the pieces. And my daughter getting into Lego. So I looked at the droid arm is where this coral reef all started. And I was looking at it and like, that's a staghorn coral right there. And it all began from there and just emerged into this this thing. And part of the idea is like, is to give some, just give someone a look at something that's so fragile. And it's something near and dear to me is these reefs are disappearing. So it is kind of like the name Fragile Reef is a two, the Legos are fragile, but also, you know, the nature of the reef itself.
Right, you're really helping raise awareness, which is great. So if you want to, you mentioned the droid arms there, but there's so many other amazing ways you've used pieces in here. Take us through a few of your favorites and kind of how this all came together.
Absolutely. The jellyfish were early on too. I saw that Friends umbrella piece, perfect for the top of a jellyfish. Definitely had to put those in. When the beehive came out, so I have upside down beehives, perfect sponge. Absolutely, like I knew I had to have that one in. I've also, right below that, I use those dimension discs. That's a fun, finally use that piece for something. So those are table corals made out of the dimension discs. Let's see, the elephant trunks for the anemones. I've got two of those guys, work perfect. Really fun use of that piece.
You've been able to attach like the fish with the little hook piece there.
Yeah, got the clownfish in there. You got to, little Nemos. And early on, I knew I had to have lots of fish. So I had to figure out how do I suspend a whole school of fish. So using the droid arms again, hundreds and hundreds of droid arms attached to those clear bars. And that was like, I knew that that would help this look for sure.
Right. So you, and then underneath all this, you got kind of the basic rock work. So is that where you started and then added all of the colorful kind of vegetation?
Yeah, absolutely. I started with a plan. I knew I wanted a beach area, or at least, you know, a sandy area. I wanted a deeper ocean area. And I knew I wanted topography. I wanted it to move upwards as you looked at it. So you could see every, at least most of the things in the back. So laid out that plan. It used to be half this size last year, so it's doubled in size. It may double next year. And then just kind of, I knew where corals belong, like, you know a bit about corals. And we're, so trying to pick the species where they would probably naturally occur was part of this too.
Right. So what were some of the challenges? Obviously, you've got so many different small parts and everything you're trying to keep together here. And maybe some tips you'd have for other people looking to do this type of building where you get a lot of tiny pieces to recreate this.
One is buy more than you think you need. That's first tip, because some of these corals have 300, 400, 500 pieces, a single coral. They just eat up pieces. So get more than you think. Be aware that things are going to break. This is very fragile, like, which is good. I mean, it's a reef. It should be fragile, but things break all the time. When I move it, every time it breaks. But what's fun is every time I move it, it kind of changes a little. So I put things in different places. I'm like, oh, that might look good there this time. And it's just, so just have fun with it and really try to play around with all those little pieces Lego has and think outside of the box or outside of the brick.
And then you've also got some actual, like the human divers and the shark back there. Talk about some of that.
Yeah, so I wanted to definitely have some minifig interaction. I'm a scuba diver, a snorkeler, so I definitely want to have some photographers in, some spear fishermen. I've got Benny and Emmett in the back. Benny thinks that the great white is coming after him, so he's pretty freaked out, but the great white doesn't want anything to do with Benny. He's going after the school of fish. And a couple Easter eggs in here. We've got Mermaid Batman riding the shark, for sure.
A must-have, obviously.
Totally. And Ariel is in the back. She's got all of her treasures in her little cave in the back. So I had to have a couple little Easter eggs. And then I do have a shipwreck, which was my daughter's idea. Shout out to Avon. So had to have something that, you know, like a pirate ship crashed along the edge of the reef. and it's real life too. So the Great Barrier Reef in Australia was definitely part of my inspiration. There's lots of shipwrecks that have crashed on that reef. So some skeletons, treasure, that kind of thing.
Exactly. So you mentioned you're a teacher. Is this the type of thing, would you ever bring this into a classroom and use this in lessons or anything like that?
Yep, absolutely. Actually, I'm going to bring it straight to school after this event. And if I could shout out to my school, PCIA, the Owls, love you guys. We'll see this soon in the class.
That's great. So not only can you display it really neat at the show and impress, you know, the Lego builders, but it's a great teaching tool as well.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I use Lego in the classroom a lot. I have in my biology class, we build Lego cells. So I have the students like, think about if you were to make a cell and all the organelles in the cell, what would they look like? So I love to use Lego in the classroom, even for high school kids. It works great. It works great.
And I think you even won an award here at the show as well.
Yeah, I did. I won an award for the mixed theme. Super excited. This is my first convention. I've been building Lego my whole life, but first convention, and just an amazing event. I love this event.
Yeah. Well, congratulations on that, and I mean, just a wonderful build once again. Thanks so much for bringing it out to the show.
Absolutely. Thanks for talking.